I've said before, I want to keep things as balanced as possible here on this channel. So as well as talking about all the amazing benefits of eating a plant-based diet, we must also discuss all the potential downsides and what we can do to mitigate them. And in this video, Dr. Greger is going to share some new information from the Biobank study on a deficiency found in plant-based eaters that could have, quote, serious consequences. And then come back and look at a simple fix and how to avoid this deficiency.
You know something? This is interesting. This is a new finding. You know, one thing that we've always said, or certainly I've always said, is that although people eating plant-based diets have lower ferritin levels, this measure of stored iron, those eating plant-based diets don't have higher rates of iron deficiency anemia, which is what really we care about. And in fact, there may actually be benefits to having low iron stores. People with higher ferritin levels have higher cancer rates, blah, blah, blah. Okay, you know, iron's this double-edged sword. So it seemed like those eating plant-based are just like at the perfect kind of sweet spot. And there really haven't been studies showing higher rates of actual anemia among people eating plant-based until now. On Biobank study out of UK, wonderful study looking at 500,000 people. We have over a dozen years now and thousands of vegetarians and vegans. Before we had like Adventist 2, we had Epic Oxford, but Biobank's coming in strong, coming in hot. When you're able to study, I forget, like, you know, 10,000 vegetarians or something, they actually found significantly higher rates. It was a small amount. It was like, I forget, something like 7% iron deficiency anemia among omnivores and like 12%, but it was statistically significant. And so no longer can we say those eating more plant-based don't actually have higher rates of iron deficiency anemia. So it's something that we have to consider. And really, it's a matter of, you know, iron-rich foods, not drinking tea with meals. Tea is wonderful, but drink it between meals. And vitamin C-rich foods at your meals, because, you know, iron deficiency anemia can have serious consequences in terms of not just energy levels, but kind of in terms of immune function. And so, yeah, we definitely want to avoid that.
So one of the ways we can avoid iron deficiency anemia on a plant-based diet is to ensure every time we eat iron-rich foods, we also have vitamin C-rich foods in our stomach at the same time. This study, where researchers gave 100 milligrams of vitamin C at lunch and at dinner to anemic children for 60 days, saw a drastic improvement in their iron levels, with most making a full recovery. This study showed similar findings. So here's a table of some vitamin C-rich foods and iron-rich foods. Now, what's fascinating is one of those vitamin C-rich fruits in that first list was found to be able to repair your DNA when eaten every day. We'll look at this next.